Good morning. My name is Sonia David. I am from the Department of Psychology, Jain University, Bangalore, and my research topic is film-based counseling on adolescent body image, a pilot study. It is an honor and a pleasure to be here, so thank you for having me. Moving on, the need of the study. The prevalence of body image is growing rapidly amongst adolescents. Indians influenced by films and other visual media forms have drastically changed individuals' mindsets, and introducing a film-based intervention, which is the need of my study, to promote positive body image and psychological flexibility. Coming to the background, even though related literatures involve clinical disorders and lifestyle of individuals as an influencing factor, this study will mainly focus on how film-based interventions affect body image. The review of related literatures, as we see, involve how media influences body image among adolescents. Due to the advancement in technology and the COVID-19 pandemic, social networking sites and various forms of media have been overused by several adolescents in the form of social media as well as online schooling. Now, there are several studies also indicating how adolescents idealize themselves by looking at role models involving perfect physical features, which has influenced an increase and in screen time as well. There are several research studies also proving that background and culture have been a major role in adolescents' body image with respect to the kind of content that they are exposed to through various forms of media. The theoretical framework I have chosen is a social learning theory, which is also known as observational learning experience, where several adolescents tend to mimic behaviors that they see on social media. There are studies conducted proving that Instagram has been a major factor in helping children and adolescents build their identity to alter themselves, of especially altering their physical sense of self pertaining to the models that they watch. Now, there are studies also indicating how adolescents watch TV shows with characters that are very similar to themselves, indicating, you know, that also help build their sense of identity. Acquired observational learning from visual culture forms is also a very shaping factor in individuals' attitudes and actions. The research gap identification that we found was a population gap, where studies on adolescents are quite scarce, theoretical gap, where there is a lack of specific theory on film therapy, as well as methodology gap, where using film as intervention methods and counseling strategies is not really there in the research universe. My objectives are to determine the effect of film-based counseling intervention model on the level of body image dissatisfaction among school-going adolescents, and to understand the cause of the alteration in body image dissatisfaction due to the said intervention. Research question: what is the effect of film-based counseling on the level of body image dissatisfaction among adolescents? There is no significant difference in the level of body image dissatisfaction among adolescents due to the film-based intervention model. My research methodology is a mixed method, one group pretest posttest design, where the dependent variable is body image dissatisfaction and the independent variable is film-based counseling intervention. My methodology, the inclusion criteria is 13 to 17 year old school going adolescents that are all based in Bangalore. I chose 11 adolescents based on judgment sampling, where they had high scores in BSQ 34. The measures that I used were a body shape questionnaire, film based intervention module, demographic details sheet, and video feedback form. The variables, as mentioned earlier, the independent variable was the film based film therapy intervention module, and the dependent variable was the body image dissatisfaction. The plan of analysis, as you can see, that the BSQ 34 is a self-report questionnaire that measures the degree of body image dissatisfaction or the body shape dissatisfaction. The 6-point Likert scale in the 34-item questionnaire required participants to rank certain items based on themselves, their bodies, and how they feel about their bodies. The video feedback form consisted of 10 questions that were obtained by the researcher with regards to the feedback of the participant. The short films for the study were selected using the following criteria: importance of appropriate developmental stage, the closeness of issue match, and the right timing of the therapy, which is very important. Now, as you can see in qualitative analysis, the thematic analysis was based on Furman in 2008, which consisted of 4 different steps: assessing the repeated statements, phrases, and words by participants in the video feedback worksheet. Codes were generated by the researcher, wherein initial themes for each question by each participant was considered. Further coding was done by kind of clubbing those same themes and refining the same. And we used synonyms of the same themes that were similar in the context and the mood of the interviewee. There was informed consent form, not just by the school, but also by parents because we were working with minors. We also collected the client informed consent form, which involved the enhancement and the level of comfort in the counseling process to promote positive and honest responses. Also, confidentiality was broken based on the intensity of the unhealthy behaviors expressed by the child, which was self-harm or harm to others. Coming to the findings, now bootstrapping method is basically a resampling technique used to estimate statistics on a population by sampling a data set with replacement. Since the sample size was 11 and it was very low to administer a t-test on the samples, the researcher bootstrapped the sample size, multiplying it by 4, making the sample 44 for accurate statistical results. Now in table 2, we can see that the t score is 9.024. We will definitely come back to this later. Before that, we'll go on to the qualitative analysis. The qualitative analysis involved thematic analysis. Now, there were 5 major themes that we came up with: acceptance of their body. The participants also exclaimed the challenges that they faced while accepting themselves in the past and dealing with their body image concerns. Awareness, becoming more aware and more conscious of their bodies when they were around others in social situations. They also spoke about a change in their perspective through positive reframing, enhancing the level of awareness. Empathy, understanding oneself and others around them, encouraged them to stand up to bullies and haters and support others even when they saw bully victims. Participants repeatedly mentioned that the videos were so easy to understand and could relate to themselves and others around them. Empowered to change, there was a significant progress of change in positive attitude amongst all participants collectively in 6 different sessions of the intervention module. Last was reflective or reflection. The participants were reflective about their experiences, and this emotion continued through the 6 sessions in the intervention module. They understood the importance of introspection as well. As you can see, the results, according to table 1, the t-value can be computed by dividing the mean by standard error, as we all know it. This implies the t-value in table 1 would be 9.692, which is quite similar to the t-value in table 2. Now, according to table 2, the t of 44 samples is 9.042, which means that the study rejects the null hypothesis. The researcher has also found enough evidence to suggest that in actuality, the difference between the two means, which is the pre-test and the post-test, are significantly different. The t-test was conducted at a 95% confidence level. Therefore, the researcher is 95% confident that the body image dissatisfaction was higher before the intervention and was significantly decreased after the intervention. We came up with 3 different implications. First is the film therapy. Since there have only been a handful of research studies done as film using films or video as a base of therapy in intervention modules, further research may well focus on the same. Context and background: the intervention model used in the study does not necessarily pertain to adolescents with body image concerns because the themes are so generic they can be used in different population on a repertoire of concerns as well. Educational settings: using films or videos as a basis of learning is not well popularized in schools and colleges today. More research studies aiming at the same to help students in life skills, not just in life skills actually, but also teaching core subjects in schools such as maths or science, can popularize the use of video-based content among children of all ages. Scope for future research: we found emotional intelligence research as one of the major scopes, where themes found in the study were so relevant to determining the emotional intelligence of the adolescents. Social learning theory: this study enhances the accuracy of the observational learning experience of participants. And film-based intervention, where research studies using film as interventions can be conducted on so many more different samples. Thank you so much for having me. Thank you. I'm open to any questions.